Okay, so now we will start with chapter number one. We'll start with chapter number one, food. Where does it come from? So the first thing we need to study is what is food? So anything that we eat to live, it is called as food. We need food to live. And food is necessary for us because it provides us the material that is required for the growth of the body, and it gives energy to do work. So food is what? How can you define food? Any substance that is eaten to do work, to grow, to maintain our body and to remain healthy is known as food. And this food, it provides nutritional support to our body. All the essential nutrients like carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals we get from the food that we eat. So there are varieties of food that we eat. Okay, so we eat different types of foods like rice, pulses, bread, vegetables, eggs. Now, how is this food prepared? We need different ingredients to prepare the food. So the materials that are needed to prepare any of the food item are known as ingredients. So two or more than two ingredients are needed to prepare a dish. If we need to prepare any of the dish, we need two or more than two ingredients. Example, if you want to prepare boiled rice, so you need rice, you need water. So rice and water, they are the ingredients that are used to prepare the dish known as boiled rice. Now, instead of boiled rice, if you want to prepare some pulao, okay, or the biryani, you say, so you will need spices, you will need oil, and different kinds of vegetables will be used to prepare that dish. Now, how vegetable curry is prepared? Vegetables, salt, water, and spices, these are the ingredients that are required to prepare vegetable curry. So these are the ingredients, means the substances or the materials that are required to prepare any of the dish of food is known as ingredients. Now, there are two main sources of food: plants and animals. They are the main sources of food. From plants, we get grains, we get pulses, we get oil, we get fruits, vegetables, sugar, spices, tea, and coffee. These are the food items that we get from plants. And animals give us milk, chicken, meat, fish and honey. So these are plant and animal, they are the main sources of food, and these are the varieties of food item that we get from plants and animals. Now, as you studied in chapter number one, that there are more than one plant parts and they are also edible, means you can eat them. So plant roots as food, which all means the roots of which all plant you can eat. So we can eat the root of radish. Radish means mooli. Carrot, turnip, potato, sweet potato, beetroot, etc. So you can eat the roots of these food, these plants. You can see in the picture. Radish, beetroot, turnip, okay, this all sweet potato, these are the plants or means the fruits of these plants you can eat. Now, stem, which all plants, the stem are edible, like ginger, potato, onion, these are the stems which we can eat. Now, plant leaves as food, we eat spinach, palak, mustard, cabbage, lettuce, etc. These are the leaves of the plants that we eat. Now, flowers as food. Banana and pumpkin. These are the flowers of the plants that we eat. Now, fruits, you know varieties of fruits. Guava, apple, banana, mango, papaya. These are the fruits that we eat. So, this is how various parts of the plants are edible. You can eat the stem of the plant. You can eat the root of the plant. You can eat the leaves of the plant. You can eat the fruit of the plant. You can even eat the flower of the plant. So, these are the edible parts of the plant. Now, more things are there. Seeds. We eat various seeds that we obtain from the plants that are wheat, maize, maize matlab bhutta, okay, rice, Bengal gram, chana, kala chana, okay, these are the seeds that we eat. Now, sprouts. What are sprouts? See, when the seed germinates, the germination of the seed is also known as sprout. When the seed germinates, the seed is known as sprout. Okay, so how the sprouted seeds look? So what you have to do is you have to soak any black gram or any that moong dal in water for overnight. And for the when you soak that overnight, next day you remove the water and tie that in one cotton or muslin cloth. The gram seeds or the moong dal, you tie in the cotton cloth, you leave that seeds for 2 or 3 days. After 2 or 3 days, you will see white color sprouts arising. So these are the sprouts. This means that the seeds have started germinating. Now comes the animal products as food. We get milk, we get egg, we get meat, honey, fish, etc. from the animals. Now buffaloes and cow, they give us milk. Hen and duck, they give us egg. We get meat from goat, chicken, hen, etc. And fish, we get from fish. Obviously, it is a seafood. Honey is produced by the honey bees. They collect nectar from the flowers and convert it into honey. And it is rich in sugar and minerals. So these are the animal products that we use as food. So this was just a short revision of chapter number 1. If anyone is having any doubt in chapter number 1, you can ask me now. Anyone having any doubt? Turnip in Hindi is known as shalgam. Turnip is known as shalgam. Now in chapter number 1, hurry up beta, if anyone is having any doubt, you can clear now in chapter number 1. In chapter number 1, if anyone is having any doubt, you can ask now. Bajra is also a kind of grain, like wheat, like maize, that's also bajra, like that in the same manner. Okay, so now I will start with chapter number 2. So the next chapter is components of food. So in this chapter, you will study about the various components that are present in your food. So the first thing that we studied in the first chapter was what is food? So any of the substance that we eat that is required for the growth, for the repairment and for maintaining our body is known as food. So it gives the fuel to our body. Like in the same manner, the vehicles, they run when we add petrol to them. In the same manner, our body runs when we eat food. So all living organisms, plants, animals, every living organism requires food to live. We get food from plants and animals. So just now we studied about the various sources of food that we get from plants and animals. So now comes what are the necessities of food? What are the important features? Why we require food? The first thing is that food helps us to grow. We grow because we eat food. And food gives us energy. We do all kinds of work because we eat food. The next is to remain healthy, we need food. If you want to be healthy, fit and fine, you need to eat food. And the useful substances in food that give us energy, that help us to grow, and that help us to remain healthy, they are known as nutrients. So nutrients are the essential components that are present in our food and that is required by our body. Now the various components, the nutrients that are present in our food are carbohydrates, fats, vitamins, minerals, proteins, roughage, and water. So these are the components of food. They are known as nutrients. They are the essential components that are required by our body, that are needed by our body. So the first major nutrient is carbohydrate. Carbohydrates, they give us energy. Carbohydrates give us energy to do work. That's why carbohydrates are also known as energy-giving food. They give us energy. They give us instant energy. See, glucose is present in the form of starch and sugar. When you drink glucose, you get instant energy because starch and sugar is present. And as you have studied that the two main type of carbohydrates that are present in our food are in the form of starch and sugar. So these carbohydrates, they give energy to our body. See, rice is the main nutrient that is present in rice is carbohydrate. In wheat, carbohydrate is present. In potato and sweet potato, carbohydrate is present. In maize means bhutta, and in sugar cane, carbohydrate is present. Okay, so this is what carbohydrate is. It mainly gives us energy to perform the work. That's why it is known as energy giving food. Now, the next type of major nutrient is protein. So proteins, they are needed for growth and repairment of our body. That's why they are known as body building foods. Proteins are known as body building foods because they help in growth and repairment of our body. So the food items that are rich in proteins are pulses, milk. Milk preparation means the various products that we get from milk, meat, fish, and egg. They are the food items that are rich in proteins. Milk, it is very nutritious and it is a rich source of protein. And milk also gives calcium for our healthy bones. So eggs of chicken, they are also very rich source of protein. Meat, pulses, they are also the sources of protein. We get protein from meat and pulses. Pulses means dal. Paneer, it is also known as cottage cheese, and it is also a very good source of protein. Now comes the next type of nutrient that is present in our food, that is fat. And fat gives us more energy than carbohydrate. It gives us more energy than carbohydrate. That's why it is also known as, means that's why it is said that fats are the stored food, because whatever food we are eating, it gets stored in the form of fat in our body. So food items that are rich in fats are various oils or the oily foods. Okay, the junk food like chocolate, cake, donuts, cookies. Okay, these are the fat food items that are rich in fats. Now, obesity. You can see this fat person. So what happens if you eat too much of fats? If you focus on too much of fatty food, then you suffer from the disease that is known as obesity. You can see this boy, one hand hot dog, ice cream, pizza, burger. He's eating all this and he's not performing any physical activity. He's not doing any exercise. So he's becoming fat and fat day by day. So that condition is known as obesity. If you eat too much of fatty food, if you will eat too much of junk food or the fatty food, you will suffer from the disease known as obesity. Now comes the next major nutrient, that is vitamins. And vitamins, they protect our body against diseases. They keep our eyes, bones and gums healthy. So various types of vitamins that is given in your book are vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin D, vitamin E, and vitamin K. So sources of vitamin A are carrot, papaya, egg, broccoli. Broccoli means the green color gobi that comes, okay? Fish, mangoes. So these are the basic sources of vitamin A. And you all know that if you don't take vitamin A in your diet, then you will suffer from the deficiency disease, that is night blindness. You will not see in the night properly. Your eyesight will become weak and weak. So that's why you have to take vitamin A in your diet. Next is vitamin B. See, it plays a main role in maintaining our good health. The energy level is maintained when you take vitamin B in your diet. And if you don't take vitamin B, then you suffer from the disease known as beriberi. And the symptoms of the disease are weak muscles and very little energy to do work. That's why if you need good health and you need energy to do work, then you have to take vitamin B in your diet. Now the next is vitamin C. See, vitamin C is needed by our body. It is needed by our skin, okay? And the deficiency disease that is caused by vitamin C is scurvy. Means bleeding gums. Your gums in your present in your teeth, they will start bleeding if you don't take vitamin C in your diet. The next is vitamin D. So vitamin D is required to keep our bones healthy. And the main source of vitamin D is sunlight. and the disease that is caused due to deficiency of vitamin D is rickets. So you have to take vitamin D in your diet, and that's why it is advised that for 5 to 10 minutes daily, you have to sit in sunlight so that your body gets natural vitamin D. Next is vitamin E. So it is required for keeping our skin healthy. To keep our skin healthy, we need vitamin E. Vitamin K, it is required for blood coagulation. Means whenever you get a cut, okay, blood starts coming. And if you don't have enough of vitamin K in your body, then your blood will not clot. Jamega nahi blood, okay, it will start, it will move on flowing and flowing. So that's why to coagulate the blood, matlab blood ko rokne ke liye, vitamin K is required. Next type of nutrient is minerals. So these minerals are required in very small amounts in our body, but they are also very important for proper growth and for good health. So these are some of the minerals: iron, calcium, phosphorus, iodine. These are the various minerals that are required by our body. In our course, which all minerals we have to study? We have to study calcium. So calcium, it is required to keep our bones and our tooth healthy. Iodine, it prevents us from goiter. And iron, it provides enough of blood in our body. So these are the minerals that you all have to study. Now, with these major nutrients, we also require water. So half of our body weight is water. Why do we need water? It enables us to swallow and digest our food. Our food gets easily digested when we drink water. We have to drink 6 to 8 glasses of water every day. You all are taking every nutrient, each and every nutrient in your diet. But if you are not drinking enough of water, then these nutrients will not be absorbed by your body. That's why you have to take enough of water in each day. Now the next is roughage. So what roughage is? See, it does not provide any nutrient to our body, but it helps to get rid of undigested food. The food that is not digested by our body, that is removed from our body by the help of roughage. So this food is required for growth, to give energy and to remain healthy. Now comes what is balanced diet. A diet that contains all the nutrients in equal amount along with water and roughage, that diet is known as balanced diet. Each and every nutrient is present in the meal, then that meal will be known as balanced meal. So this was chapter number 2, the short revision of chapter number 2. Now, if anyone is having any doubt in chapter number 2, you can ask in the chat box. Don't switch on your mic, beta Ritesh.
Yes, ma'am.
Anyone having any doubt? Yes, we means we get fat when you eat outside. Means whenever you will eat junk food, okay, or the food that contains oil in it, you get fat, and that condition is known as obesity. Vitamin K that is required for blood coagulation. Means whenever you get cut, after some time your blood stops flowing from that cut. That is due to vitamin K that is present. Okay. See this makhana, Bhupendra, it is a dry fruit, beta. It is a dry fruit. Vitamin K, you have not seen in that PPT, beta. Bhupendra, I showed you the PPT. Examples were given. Broccoli, spinach, these are all. Vitamin K is present. Broccoli means that green gobi. Beriberi, it is caused due to deficiency of vitamin B. When you don't take vitamin B in your diet, then you will suffer from beriberi. Okay, so now I will start with chapter number 3, fiber to fabric.
Ma'am, we can leave the meeting.
I think. Am I audible to all of you?
Where is ma'am?
Where is ma'am?
Is that
अभी रुक जाओ ना।
One of you can tell me from which part my voice was not coming? Any one of you?
Ma'am, from fiber to fabric.
Okay. I will explain you once again. Okay, so we will study about chapter number 3, fiber to fabric. And in this chapter, you will study what fibers are. So the definition of fiber that you can give is the thin strands of threads that can still be converted into thinner strands that are fibers. And we obtain the clothes means from these fibers. The two types of fibers that we will study are natural fibers and synthetic fibers. Is the screen visible? Anyone can unmute your mic and say, am I audible and is my screen visible?
Ma'am, your screen is not visible.
Okay. Now you can switch off your mic. Okay. Now is it visible, Anresha?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now switch off your mics. So we will study about chapter number 3, fiber to fabric. So fibers are the thinner strands of threads that can still be converted into more thinner strands. They are known as fibers. And two types of fibers are natural and man-made fibers. So natural fibers, they are obtained from plants and animals. Example, cotton, wool, jute, and silk. The synthetic fibers, they are obtained in laboratories, means they are prepared in laboratories. They are known as synthetic fibers. Example, nylon, polyester, makhmal, fur, etc. Now, the first basic type of natural fiber that we will study is cotton. So, cotton fiber is obtained from the fruits of the cotton plant. We require black soil and warm climate for that. So, these fruits of the cotton plant, they are also known as cotton balls. Okay, as they mature, means as the fruits are grown up, they burst open. As they burst open, the cotton fibers are obtained, and these fibers, cotton seeds are separated from these fibers by the process of ginning. This is the machine that you can see in which ginning is performed, and traditionally it was done using hands. So ginning is what? When separation of seeds from the fibers is known as ginning. Now the next process is spinning. Now the conversion of fibers into yarn is known as spinning, and it is done using the machines known as chakli and charkha. Now after these spinning machines are there, when large quantity of fiber needs to be converted into yarn, so spinning machines are used. Now the next is weaving. When these yarns are converted into fabric, that process is known as weaving, and basically looms are used. It can be hand loom or it can be power loom. Looms are used in the process of weaving. Now, silk is not in your syllabus, wool is not in your syllabus. So the next type of fiber that we will study is jute. So you all know that jute fiber is obtained from the stem of the jute plant, and it is harvested at its flowering stage. And as soon as the flower starts coming, these jute plants are cut, and the stems are immersed in water. Pani mein dal ke rakh dete hain usko. And after few days, when these stem gets rot, jab sad jati hai these stems, then these fibers are separated by hand. So in this manner, the jute fibers are obtained. And man-made and synthetic fibers are those fibers that are prepared by using chemicals. So is chapter number 3 clear? Is chapter number 3 clear to you all? Okay. Fluffy means soft, beta.
Ma'am, what is ginning?
Don't unmute your mic, beta. Whatever you want to ask, you ask in the chat box. So you all mention in the chat box that whether you all want me to explain chapter number 4 means the revision of chapter number 4, or you all want me to end the class. You want the revision of chapter number 4, yes or no? Fibers and fabrics. See, fibers are the thinner strands that are obtained from the sources, and fabrics are the pieces of cloth. Akshar don't want the revision. Okay. And rest other wants the revision of chapter number 4. Okay, so just 5 minutes. Give me 5 minutes. I will explain you the chapter number 4 also, those who want. Once again, a reminder. After this class, I will give you one revision test, and that test you have to complete till timing 5 p.m. Okay, till 5 p.m. that link will be open. After that, you will not be able to submit the test. Then don't message me, ma'am, my net was not working or anything. So be prepared for that test, revision test of periodic 1. After this class, I will send you the, in the group, I will send you. Now, I will just give you a quick revision of chapter number 4. Don't unmute your mic, Akshat. Okay, so now we will study chapter number 4, sorting materials into groups. Now we all know there are varieties of materials around us, and if we need that material very easily, so we need to group those materials. We need to group those materials for proper classification of those materials. Both decks and chair, they are made up of plastic. Pen and dustbin, they are made up of plastic, wood. So both decks and chair, they are made up of wood, and pen and dustbin are made up of plastic. So according to the materials of the object, we can divide the object into various groups. You can see pen, chair, bed, knife, these are made up of these different materials. Plastic, metal, wood, steel, iron, wood, steel, iron, steel. So these are the objects that are made up of different types of materials. Now, we will study about the various properties of materials. The first thing that you need to study is that these are the materials that we use in our daily life. Desk, chair, books, notebooks, okay, pencil, backpack, these are the things that we use in our daily life. Now, according to the properties of materials, the various materials can be grouped. So the properties are appearance, hardness, solubility or insolubility, density means they float or they sink, and the transparency. So according to the first property that is appearance, the objects are divided into two types that have luster, means that have shine, and the objects that do not have shine. So lustrous objects and the non-lustrous objects. See, the lustrous item, you can see gold, silver, copper, they have luster. Non-lustrous, sulfur, phosphorus, these don't have luster, means they don't have shine in them. Now the next is hardness. On the basis of this property, the objects are again divided into two types, means soft and hard. The materials that can be pressed easily, they are known as soft, and the materials that cannot be pressed easily, they are known as hard materials. The next property is solubility. On this property, the objects are further divided into soluble or insoluble. Means the materials that disappear or they dissolve completely, they are known as soluble material. Example, sugar and salt, they completely dissolve in water, so they are soluble. And the materials that cannot be dissolved completely in water, they are known as insoluble material, like stones and clothes. They cannot be dissolved in water, so they are insoluble materials. Now the next is floating or sinking. The objects that float on the surface of the water, they are grouped in one category, and the objects that sink in water, jo doob jate hain, they are grouped in one category. Now, on the basis of transparency, the objects are further divided into transparent objects, translucent objects, and opaque objects. So, switch off your mic. So, the transparent objects like glass and clear water, means the materials of the objects through which we can see clearly, they are known as transparent objects. And the translucent objects are those means through which we can see partially, aadha dekh sakte hain. They are transparent objects like butter paper. And the opaque objects are the objects through which we cannot see, like wood, cardboard. They are opaque objects. See, you can see this transparent, all light is passing. In this translucent, some light is passing. And this opaque, no light is passing. You can see some of the objects that are transparent, translucent, and opaque. So this was a quick revision of chapter number 4. If anyone is having any doubt from chapter number 1 to chapter number 4, you can ask in the chat box. I will give the test in Microsoft. I will share the link that you have to do. Okay, now if anyone is having any doubt from chapter number 1 to chapter number 4, you can ask me. Revision test beta, from chapter number 1 to chapter number 4, all the chapters I am taking one short revision test. That's why in this class I explained all the chapters in short. Yes, just now I will give until 5 p.m. you have to complete that test. Now, if anyone is having any doubt, you can ask your doubts, clear up your doubts. I'm giving you 5 more minutes. You can clear up your doubts. Materials that I need to make so far. See, beta. First of all, wood is used. Okay, next, any type of cloth material. Sponge is used. Okay, spring is used, means metal is used. So these are the materials that are used to make sofa. Anyone having any doubt? Akshat, you don't need to giggle, beta. ऐसे दांत दिखाने की जरूरत नहीं है. Now, anyone having any doubt? Okay, so your class is over for today. Just now, I'm forwarding you one link. You have to open that link. You solve the paper, okay? And you have the time till 5 p.m. After that time, you will not be able to solve that test. So be prepared. I'm sending you that link. Okay, students, now you all can leave the class. Thank you for your cooperation.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, bye, bye.